and welcome to another tips and tricks video for this channel. I am Bianca, and for today, I will be sharing with you all some tips and tricks for the brand new camping sim from Spryfox, where we play as a brand new spirit scout on their first ever solo excursion into the titular haunted campgrounds of Cozy Grove. And tricks may be geared a little bit more towards beginners. So if you've been playing the game for a while now through the Apple Arcade, please keep that in mind. There are, after all, people just getting introduced to this game for the first time. And although the game is chill and laid back and relaxing as they come, it can get quite confusing, as there are certain things in the game that the game doesn't outright tell you. With that in mind, let's begin. Tip number one, but this might serve more like a warning than an actual tip, especially for people who are too impatient to play the game as it is intended to be played. Do not, in any circumstances, cheat on this game by time traveling. Time traveling, like how it is done with Animal Crossing, is done by changing the date and time of whatever console or handheld device you are playing this game on. While that may seem enticing, as it allows you to play and progress the game without limits, it has been reported that doing so greatly enhances the risk of your save files being corrupted, with the only fix for the game to be playable again is for players to delete their files and start over from scratch. Tip number two, expand. The whole point of the game is helping souls trapped in Camp Cozy Grove while also bringing the camp back to its former glory. With each help you provide to the spirits, the more colorful and vibrant the world becomes. That is also true for each spirit log you feed Flamey, your campfire spirit and fairy companion. What you may not be aware of is that you can expand the light and color in the world by using lamps. Simply place the lamps by the edge of each lighted and colored area to expand its reach. Connect these lamps and you can expand the colors even further. You can tell how far the light will go when you are about to place these lanterns, as they are denoted by a radius around the item. This is very much something you should be doing, as you can only interact with items such as fruit-bearing trees and ore deposits, just to name a few, if they are within the colored areas. Note that color can fade in a day-to-day basis, so you may want to check up on the places and ghosts you've already rejuvenated and simply answer more of their requests or place new lanterns and light decorations to bring the colors back. Tip number three, each of our islands are different from each other, and although the general area that each ghost are in are basically the same, some items for their fetch quests and small landmarks are placed differently for each player. Because of this, hunting down the lost objects might not go the same way with you as it did with me. So, how do you go about getting help in finding these items? Well, you can and should make use of the clues provided in your quest log, especially with how well hidden some of these items are. If you still cannot make heads or tails of where to find the item you are looking for, you can ask Charlotte for help. She will provide you with a marker of where the item you are searching for is, provided you pay up 100 coins for her services. Tip number 4. Gather and burn. Gathering items in Cozy Grove can be done by interacting with mounds of dirt and piles of leaves. You can also harvest them from pots and trees. Doing so allows you to obtain various items used for quests, cooking, crafting, and selling. What you can gather depends on what season it is, which is mirrored with what season it currently is in real time. These gathering spots respawn over time, some within minutes, others daily or within a given time frame. The same is true for fruit-bearing trees and flowers. Now, there are items that you can't really obtain by harvesting, digging, or searching. To obtain items such as food for your pets or materials and ingredients for craftable items, you would need the services of your faithful companion, Flamey. One of the things Flamey can do is burn objects. Now, unlike what you may be thinking, this does not destroy an object, but rather transmutes it into something new. Need an iron? Ask Flamey to burn iron ores and you'll get one. Need fish bones to craft decorations? Let Flamey burn the fish you catch. Tip number 5 isn't a tip, but more of a reminder, and it is in regards with saving the game. Now, there are two ways that the game saves. The first is that it automatically does so every 5 minutes or after every important event, you know, whichever comes first when you're playing the game. The second involves you opening the options menu and clicking return to main menu. This will force the game to save. Why do I include this? Well, it's because it's something most might not know, and if they're playing on the Nintendo Switch, they just might end up closing and quitting the game without heading to the main menu to save, and they might lose some progress in doing so. Think of it as a precaution to make sure your progress does get saved. Tip number 6. Your backpack isn't really that big with the inventory space, and as far as I can tell, there is no means for you to expand it. Leaving items on the ground may seem like a good idea, but it's not something that you should really take to doing. With the exception of decorations and pets, leaving items lying on the ground for a long time will cause them to disappear forever. If you leave shells on the ground, they will also prevent new shells from spawning, which would make it difficult for you to complete your collection. One place you can store your items, however, is your camp storage. Note that when it comes to crafting, you don't need to keep the materials in your backpack. You can actually leave them in your camp storage and you will still be able to access them during crafting. Now, let's talk about time in the game. Cozy Grove, as I've mentioned before, works on real time. A new day in the game begins every 5 a.m. based on the device which you are playing it in, and the campaign will only advance if you actually played on that particular save slot. So, for example, you have 2 playthroughs and you decided to play on save 1 for today and save 2 for tomorrow. Save 1 will not advance in the number of campaign days when you play save 2 and vice versa. So why does that matter? Well, because there are some spirits, facilities, and stuff that are gated by campaign day. Likewise, shells are also given a limited number of times each day to spawn, so you may need to wait for the next campaign day if you want to collect more of them. The same goes for the mounds of dirt, leaves, and shrubberies. There are also things that are affected by real-world time, and that includes day and night lighting in the game, the appearance of the wandering merchant, fish appearing on certain months, and quests that are tied with a timer. You're also credited in the game for playing during particular months in the form of badges. Speaking of badges, that's what the next tip is about. Obtaining badges is one way to get lots of money in the game, not to mention other useful rewards for crafting. By doing tasks and requests and playing daily, you can unlock these badges and get the rewards from them. Another way you can make money is by donating shells, fish, flowers, cooked foods, ingredients, and crafting materials to Captain Snout. Each unique item you give, he gives you a reward in return for them. Money is a common reward from him, but there are also times when he will give you a rare crafting material for your trouble, so be sure to check with him regularly. Likewise, the daily mail provides you with more items each day, so be sure to check with the mailman frequently for those as well. Next up are the happiness and preferences of each item you can decorate in your camp, and that includes the pets. Each of them has certain likes and dislikes, which you can view when interacting with them or prior to putting them down. Pay attention to these and make sure to place decorations that match each item and pet's preferences to increase their happiness and make them available for harvesting. For pets, flowers, and trees, the happier they are, the rarer their rewards when harvested can be. Note that petting your pet can temporarily increase their happiness and, like your tools, there are tiers to them as well. Tip number 10, do your daily quests first. It's a good idea to do them first before you head off to do your other tasks like collecting items and selling them for money. The reason for this is that some quests require you to hand over these forageable items, and if you've already sold them and have reached the limit of collecting them, then you will have no other way to finish the quest outside of paying Mr. Kit for some of these items. Next, we'll talk about the imps. Like the other animals and pets in the game, there may be times when you see one that has a speech bubble atop its head. These imps are requesting items from you. Now, the imps are very shy and will run away if you try to get close to them. So, how are we to complete their requests? Simple, by throwing the items that they are requesting towards them. Once they've picked up the item and the icon above their head changes to a heart, then we can go close to them and interact with them. Doing so will give us a reward for our troubles. Tip number 11 is for crafting recipes. Crafting, as you guys may know by now, is a big part of Cozy Grove, not just for sprucing up the now desolate landscape of the island, but also for finishing requests from ghosts, animals, and imps. At the beginning of the game, you'll already be given access to a couple of crafting recipes courtesy of good old Jeremy. To learn more, however, a majority of recipes can be found by doing tasks like fishing, digging dirt, searching through piles of leaves, and of course, as rewards from helping the ghosts that haunt the camp. The easiest way out of all of this, however, that I've personally found is by fishing, as these recipes can be obtained quite early on in the game just by doing so. And lastly, tip number 12, prioritizing upgrades. There are many updates that can be done in Cozy Grove, and the most important one and the one that you should be focusing and prioritizing first is upgrading your tent. Upgrading the tent upgrades your camp storage and also increases the area of color in your island, which gives you more room to decorate and more items to interact with. The second you must work on is Mr. Kit's shop. Upgrading this will expand his selection, making it easier for you if you're having a hard time getting certain items. He will also make higher tier tools available for you. Just remember, if you decide to upgrade his shop, it will be closed for the entirety of the next day. Both of these upgrades will cost a fortune though, so be sure to have enough money saved up before doing so. And that's about it for this video. If you guys have any other tips that you would like to add for Cozy Grove, be sure to share them on the comment section down below. Thank you all for watching, and I'll see you all in the next one. Until then, you guys know the drill. Dream on, fly on. Bye-bye, everyone. Keep safe, stay at home. We might